Okay, we are working on a watermelon still life inspired by Frida Kahlo and Diego Rivera. We will start off by using shape templates in different styles of watermelon, different cuts. Okay. So, in order to create a very interesting still life, what you want to do is make sure that you are overlapping shapes. Also, draw very lightly. You can draw a line to separate your background from your foreground. Anywhere your lines overlapped, you can choose to erase the part you do not want. If you choose to draw your own shapes, that's okay too. Just make sure that you draw them big enough to take up the majority of your paper. After you do that, you're going to draw parts of the watermelon that will not be green, because today we are only painting monochromatic green, which is green plus white. I'm going to go ahead and draw the watermelon rind, which is the dark green part. And I'm going to draw a second line to represent where the white starts of the watermelon rind. We will paint the red part next week. Okay, when you are painting your watermelon, we know that watermelon have alternating light and dark green pattern on the outside of the watermelon. So I'm just going to start with a line that goes in the middle. And my line's kind of wavy, just to give that visual interest. And it goes to the center. Don't worry about drawing your seeds today, because we're going to paint it red and then paint it again. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off with that green. I'm just going to outline with green. I'm painting all my dark green first, and then I could come back with light green, and at the very end, if I want to add white, I can add white. You also might notice that I have a sponge here instead of a towel. I still have towels if you need a towel. But to rinse your brush, all you do is rinse in water and then make an X on your sponge. And that means it's all clean. Okay, I'm going to go in with the lighter green. Okay, I'm going to go in with my skinny brush. I'm just going to add a little bit of white in between the light and dark green. And then you could take it to the drying rack. Make sure your name and class code's on it.